Hello, everyone. I'm Crystal Heisel, and it is a delight for me to share today's devotional with you. I want to take you to a scripture passage found in Colossians, where Paul is writing to the church in Colossae while he's in prison in Rome. It's a time in the early church where there's a lot of conflict and chaos with who people are choosing to worship. You know, some believers were attempting to combine other religious practices and false teachings and whatever else that looked appealing to them and mixing it in with Christianity. Well, in other words, it sounds so much like the world that we live in today. We see people picking and choosing what they want to believe and then mixing it in with Christianity and calling it truth. Well, Paul writes to the church and he brings clarity and guidance to what it looks like to turn their lives completely over to Christ and to worship Him and Him alone. I love how Paul spurs us on in our walk with Christ. You see, receiving Christ is only the beginning of our journey. There's so much more for us as we lean in and follow the leadership of Jesus. And when we do, we grow. Growth in our spiritual life. Growth happens in our relationships and in our relational health. And there is healing in our physical and our emotional well-being. I want to take you to Colossians 2:7. It says this: let your roots grow down into Him, and let your lives be built on Him. Then your faith will grow strong in the truth you were taught, and you will overflow with thankfulness. Well, as a wife and mother and grandmother, and pastor, friend, this is my prayer for me, but it is also my prayer for you. May we let our roots grow down into Him and let our lives be built on Him. Then our faith will grow strong in the truth we were taught, and we will overflow with thankfulness. When we make this our prayer, we are being built up and we are being strengthened in our faith and we are being guided by Christ. There is the good news of Jesus Christ. Christ wants to guide us. Christ wants to help us with our problems. He wants to give us wisdom in dealing with our relationships and with our children and in our marriage. He wants to give us wisdom in our businesses and in our management skills and in our people skills. You know, I have recently been trying my best to grow some plants, and some of my plants are doing great. And to be honest, I also have some that are not doing so great. I have some that they just need some extra room in their containers right now, and they're waiting for me to repot them so that their roots can grow down deeper and not get choked out. Well, just like my plants draw their nourishment from the soil through their roots, you and I draw our life-giving strength through Jesus. And the deeper our roots are in Christ, the less we will be fooled by those that claim to have life's answers. The deeper our roots are in Christ, the more anchored we are in Him. And the more anchored we are in Him, the stronger we are when the storms of life come along and they try to uproot us and they try to blow us over. You know, during this past year, every single one of us have had plenty of opportunity to experience the storms of life that have just tried their best to disrupt our root system. And today, I want to specifically pray that God will cultivate the ground that we are planted in so that our spiritual root system will grow deeper and stronger than ever before. Back to our verse. In Colossians, it said that when our roots grow down deep, our faith is made stronger. I want my faith to be made stronger, don't you? Part of what helps our roots to grow down is doing exactly what you and I are doing right now, taking the time to invest in our spiritual life, just like this, through devotions and taking in God's word. Another way that will help us grow deep is through spending time worshiping God. Man, I just want to encourage you, crank up the worship music in your car, crank it up in your house, and worship our God. Declare who God is in your life. Another way to help our roots grow down deep is through prayer. My friend, there is power in prayer. There is power in your prayers. Don't ever doubt whether or not your prayers are being heard by God. James 5:16 says to us, "The prayers of a righteous person are powerful and they are effective." And you and I are called to pray. In fact, today I want us to pray over some specific areas that I want to pray, and that is over families and children and marriages. You see, the enemy would love to destroy your marriage covenant by deceiving you. He would love to fill your mind with manipulative lies. He would love for you to pull up a chair and entertain its deceptive voice. But my friend, I want to remind all of us that the deeper our root system, the more prepared you will be to fight the lies of the enemy. So I want us to pray. Would you join me? Lord, today, we want to lift up our children to you. Lord, today, we believe you are growing their faith in Jesus Christ. Lord, nothing is too great for you, and I believe you are speaking to the hearts of children and drawing them into you today. Lord, I thank you that you are giving moms and dads right now wisdom on how to raise their children. Lord, I pray over marriages. I pray for forgiveness where forgiveness is needed. Lord, I pray right now for strength to strengthen marriages. We thank you in advance for the healing, God, that you are bringing into marriages right now. Those marriages that the fabric has been frayed, you are bringing healing. Lord, I thank you that you are increasing the understanding between husbands and wives. And I pray that we would be men and women that would bring honor to you at every level. And Lord, we will be people that will honor those beside us. We will honor those in leadership above us. And Lord, we will honor those that are under our authority. Father, we bring it to you. We declare it to you. Lord, I thank you that you have given us peace. Lord, we declare the peace that you've given us. You are reigning over our homes. And Lord, we declare that you, Father, are leading us. We will be people of honor. And Lord, we give you thanks for the freedom that we have to serve you. We, Father, say today that we will never, God, take you for granted. We give you praise, God, for all that you do. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, friends.